So this is really like Mexican. Cries in Spanish. Faints in Spanish. I don't know what else in Spanish. It centers over in Spanish. What up, bitches? How's it going? That's how an evil person in a novela does it. Anyway, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to Song of the Week. I hope you guys had a very stressful week. I'm just kidding. Today we're gonna talk about the one and only Vicente Fernandez, or his nickname, El Rey de la Música Ranchera. That's really dramatic because we're Mexican and that's what we do. So we're talking about the song Para Siempre by Vicente Fernandez. So Vicente Fernandez's full name is Vicente, quotation marks, Chente, Fernandez Gomez. He was born in Huetita El Alto, Guadalajara, Jalisco. So like I said before, his most common nickname is El Rey de la Música Ranchera, the King of Ranchera Music. I have my doubts about that, but you know what? He's a great singer, so I'm just gonna let that pass. He started singing for tips on the street, believe it or not. He grew up in a ranch with his father, and when he broke through, he produced over 50 albums. Yeah, you heard that right. He has more than 50 albums. Not 50, he has more than 50. And he became a cultural icon in the Mexican culture. So if you haven't guessed it yet, Vicente Fernandez's main focus in music is ranchera. That is the type of music that mariachis play. But one of the songs of the week was his son, Alejandro Fernandez. Well, this is the dad, the head honcho, the actual cultural icon, the king of ranchera. Now let's look at the actual success of this Mexican cultural icon. I don't think people understand why he's so amazing. He actually crossed national borders with his music. He has 3 Grammys, he has 8 Latin Grammys, and he has 14 Premio Lo Nuestros. And, drumroll, he has a Hollywood star, a star on the Walk of Fame. Oh my God, yay! Proud Mexican here. And he has sold over 50 million records worldwide. 50 million! Oh my God. So we're gonna talk about Para Siempre today, which is a song slash the title of his album. And it's a very, very iconic song. As you can hear it, it's straight up ranchera, guys. It's like, you can't get any more ranchera than that, really. Except, you know, he hasn't done the Mexican, you know, scream, the ah, ha, ha, ha. Yeah, I'm gonna stop right now because I don't know how to do it. So the album Para Siempre was released in 2008. It is his 79th album. Let's just let that sink in right now. 79th album. Jesus, he's old. Para Siempre is the, like I said, the name of the album and the 3rd single of that album. The other 2 singles are called La Derrota and Estos Celos. So the song is iconic not because of its sound. Obviously, its sound is very, very, very cultural. But the reason why the song is so known is because this past informational video, I talked about the novela Fuego en la Sangre. It was a very famous novela back in the day when I was growing up. And Para Siempre, the song, was actually used for the intro of that novela. So that is actually what made it a lot more known, because that novela came out weekly and you always heard Para Siempre in the beginning. When you heard that little guitar, y'all knew this novela was gonna start, and I was so excited. This album actually got him a nomination for a Grammy, like an actual Grammy. Isn't that impressive? I'm sorry. Every time Latin artists get a nomination for an actual Grammy, I just get excited because you can tell that they're finally crossing over. People that are non-Latino are noticing our type of music, and that's very, very prideful for me because I think Latin music is amazing and it should be noticed, and it should be kind of credited because it has a unique sound to it. So when it was premiered, the song 2008, it actually peaked to number two on the Billboard's Hot Latin Songs of the Year. Yay! And it actually won a Premios Oye for the best telenovela movie / series song. So that was really cool. I'm telling you, this song was really iconic because it was hand in hand with Fuego en la Sangre, which became a very successful novela. So thanks to that and thanks to each other, these two iconic things became just part of our Mexican culture. So we sing it. That comes my favorite part of the whole damn video. Yay! I get to look up the lyrics and try and translate them for you. Yay! Look, I got a new pop-up thingy. Yay!
We are not impressed.
Shut up. So we're gonna start with the beginning because technically the beginning is, you would think that the chorus would be, but the beginning is actually the most known part because that's what they use for the theme song. So we're gonna start. Vale más un buen amor. A true love or a good love is worth more que mil costales de oro than a million sacks of gold. Vale más un buen amor. A good love is worth more. Por eso eres mi tesoro. That's why you're my treasure. Valgo mucho junto a ti. I'm worth a lot when I'm next to you or when I'm near you. Y soy muy feliz contigo, and I'm very happy with you. Vale mucho para mí. It's worth a lot to me. Con el corazón te digo. I'm telling you with my whole heart, like truthfully, with my whole heart. Olvidemos el pasado. Let's forget about the past. Y lo que diga la gente, and what the people say. Let's forget about the past and what people say. La verdad es que te amo. The truth is that I love you. Y me amas. And you love me. Para siempre. Forever. Sí. It's really dramatic. Se vale mucho un gran amor. It's worth a lot, a grand, or like a big love. Que en el perdón ha crecido. That in the forgiveness, it has grown. Or in forgiveness, it has grown. Hoy sé que el llanto sirvió. Today I know that my cry or my weeps worked. See, this is why these lyrics work better in Spanish, because in English it's less romantic and you're just like, what? That's why it's in Spanish, and that's why I'm gonna talk about this. Despacito should never be in English. I'm just saying, because it's dirty as fuck. Anyway, this is more romantic, it's fine. Yeah, so that's the lyrics. It's really pretty, it's really well, we have this word in Spanish that's called cursi, that's what it says. It basically means corny or like super corny. Like if someone says, oh my God, that's really cursi, you're like, oh, that's really fucking corny, dude. Like, what you doing? But yeah, this song is super, super cursi, but it fits because it's for a novela. That's fine. All right, so my favorite part is coming up. I'm gonna show you a little clip live. You can see the powerhouse. If Alejandro Fernandez is a powerhouse live, you're about to see the head honcho. You're about to see his dad live. This guy's voice, he can literally belt out a note in a stadium without the microphone. He's done it before, and it's friggin' amazing. Maybe I'll find that clip and I'll put it in. Who knows? I don't know. I have to find it first. But for now, here is a clip of Para Siempre. You know what? We might actually put the intro to Fuego en la Sangre.
And I was thinking about it.
So here's a clip of the song that is used for the intro. So here's the intro to the novela that has the song Para Siempre. Let's go this way.
Televisa presenta. Vale más un buen amor que mil costales de oro. Vale más un buen amor Por eso eres mi tesoro, valgo mucho junto a ti. Y soy muy feliz contigo, vales mucho para mí. Con el corazón te digo, olvidemos el pasado y lo que diga la gente. La verdad es que te amo y me amas para siempre. Olvidemos el pasado y vivamos el presente. Lo que importa es que me amas y te amo para siempre.
Sweet! I hope you guys enjoyed that clip. I'm telling you, this guy's a powerhouse. I'm just saying. Be sure to check out some of his music. I'm going to leave a link to this clip below and also a link to the music video below. That's all going to be in the description box below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Be sure to follow me on my social media on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your Saturday or whatever is left of your Saturday. So I'm gonna take this right over here because, like I said, we don't have jarritos. Sorry. Mexicana Americana. Out.
He's a pendejo. That's a pendejo. Over here is a pendejo.
Dude, there's a fucking clown over there with a fucking knife. No mames, I'm out of here.
Because I'm a pendeja. Yes, I am.
Yes, mom. All right, hold on. Well, fuck you too. All right. Ruby doesn't say bad words. What's going on? I'm sweating profusely. Can we open a window here?
Sweating is bad.